Hello, welcome to yet another video. My name is Mike Davies, and today I'll be explaining GIMP in 5 minutes. Let's dive right in. GIMP is a free and open source raster-based photo editor available for Windows, Mac, and Linux operating systems. Raster-based simply means the program uses raster graphics or pixels to display and edit images and graphical elements like shapes and text. Photoshop and Affinity Photo are other raster-based photo editors you may have heard of, and they likewise use pixels to display and edit images and other graphics. GIMP can be downloaded for free at any time from GIMP.org. Simply click the download button on the homepage and choose the Download GIMP Directly option on the downloads page. Your operating system should be automatically detected by the GIMP website. Once downloaded and opened, you can customize the way your GIMP looks, choosing from a dark or light theme, single or multicolor icons, and smaller or larger icon sizes. Plus, you can reposition, add, or remove the dockable dialogues that surround your image canvas to further customize your GIMP's layout. As I've already mentioned, GIMP is primarily a photo editor. That means it has tons of tools, features, and filters built around aiding you in editing and manipulating images. For starters, it uses a layer system, which means you can either create compositions with a single image on a single layer, or stack multiple images and layers on top of one another to create more complex compositions. It also has common adjustment tools like levels, curves, hue saturation, shadows, highlights, and exposure tools for helping you bring the best out of your photos. It also has tons of filters for useful tasks like sharpening, blurring, adding a vignette, correcting lens distortion, or creating unique image effects. Over in the toolbox, GIMP comes with dozens of useful tools that have various functions, including selection, painting, transformation, retouching, and other miscellaneous tools. You can perform basic functions with these tools like moving or aligning layers, drawing and painting in selection areas, or cropping your image. On the other hand, there are plenty of more advanced tools like the foreground select tool for background removal, heal and clone tools for image retouching, and the 3D transform tool for more advanced transformations. In addition to photo editing tools, GIMP has several built-in features for adding graphics to your images or compositions. It has a text tool, and you can combine your text with pretty much any tool or filter in GIMP to enhance or transform the text. You can draw shapes in GIMP by combining the shape selection tools with paint tools, and can also draw custom shapes with tools like the free select tool or the paths tool. Just like Photoshop and Affinity Photo, GIMP uses layer masks and blending modes to creatively combine multiple images and layers. These features make it easy to create photo manipulations like changing the colors of objects in a photo or swapping the background of an image. While GIMP does come with tons of features by default, its capabilities can also be extended with third-party plugins, fonts, brushes, patterns, and scripts. You can create these add-ons yourself or download them from any trusted third party. GIMP supports the most common font types like OpenType and TrueType, which can be downloaded from sites like Google Fonts, and even supports assets from other programs like Photoshop, meaning you can download and install Photoshop brushes to use in GIMP. Popular plugins for GIMP include Gimmick, which contains an eclectic mix of over 500 filters, and Resynthesizer, which has useful object removal tools. In addition to add-ons, GIMP can be synced with other free and open source software. For example, syncing GIMP with RAW processors like Darktable or RAW Therapy allows you to process RAW images before opening them into GIMP. GIMP supports a variety of image and file formats, including popular formats like JPEG, PNG, GIF and TIFF, and can open or export to proprietary formats from other programs like Photoshop's PSD file. However, you can always save your compositions and the layers in those compositions in GIMP's native .xcf file. If you want to learn more about the incredibly powerful and free photo editor GIMP, you can check out any of the hundreds of YouTube videos on my channel that cover a variety of subjects from the basics to more advanced techniques. I have a GIMP masterclass on Udemy with over 35 hours of content for those of you who prefer a course-based method of learning. Plus, you can get access to bonus tutorials and downloadable assets for GIMP by becoming a DMD Premium member on my site. All right, that's it for this video. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, don't forget to click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out all the relevant links from this video in the description, but thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.